Hi, this is Al Carty. I want to thank you for tuning into this very important presentation. You're watching this video for one of two reasons. Either you're looking to replace or generate an additional income stream, or you're interested in the latest, most innovative financial products that can provide not only a blanket of security for you and your family, but also substantial tax savings. What you will see and hear today is a concept that impacts people that you can be passionate about. A smarter, more complete way to save money with higher income, more benefits, and tax-free. A multi-trillion dollar business that pays billions to producers, and how you can make up for lost time and lost earnings. So here's the problem, folks. Most of the population's retirement, as a matter of fact, $17 trillion, is in an IRA, 401k, 403b, or qualified plan, and a large percentage of that money will be lost to fees and taxes. In fact, the majority will outlive their income. Number two, 70% of the population will suffer a critical or chronic illness such as a heart attack, stroke, or cancer and live to age 65, but may be financially crippled in the process. And last, but certainly not least, 44% of the adult population cannot meet their financial obligations due to economic conditions. So let's get right into it. And really, what's the solution? Well, Freedom Equity Group. And we believe we're the solution because what we're all about is freedom. As a matter of fact, we liken ourselves to a crusade because we are building financial freedom for the American family. Our mission is very, very simple. We want to show every American how to save, grow, and retire. All tax-free with living benefits. In other words, financial freedom. Freedom Equity Group is a different kind of company. And the reason for that is we've got experienced leadership. Each of our owners have 30 years of experience in the industry. And you'll see three pictures of the top here of our ownership. Ron Blumenkemper to the left, Ron Petrinovich, our CEO and president, and Bill St. Clair, our chief operating officer. They have a clean track record. They've built in one company, they've built over 48,000 agents. They've been number one producers as a producer group with many insurance companies. And the reason for that is because we've got a proven turnkey system. We've got the best team building system ever out there in the financial service business. We've got a product that fits everyone, that everyone can afford, and we've got an easy to follow income building system. Now, let me just real quick housekeeping here. What I'm about to share with you in this presentation is you're going to see some statistics, some information. This is for illustrative purposes and educational purposes. We don't proclaim to be CPAs or attorneys, so we're not giving any tax or specific legal advice. So problem number one, most of the population's retirement, $17 trillion, is in an IRA, 401k, 403b, and a large percentage of that money will be lost to fees and taxes, and the majority will outlive their income. So it's a big problem. Where do most people save for retirement today? Most people are saving in an IRA, a 401k, a qualified plan that are fully taxable. Now, how did this come about? Well, and you know, in the mid to late 70s, corporations started bringing in these qualified plans after ERISA was formed to regulate the management of these plans, and they started bringing out what was first known as the 401k. And this was the ability for you to take pre-tax dollars from your income and put it into a plan that would be tax deductible today but fully taxable in the future. And today, there are 90 million people that invest in these type of Wall Street type of accounts called qualified plans. But there are many roadblocks along the way. As a matter of fact, there are four, and we want to make sure people understand what these roadblocks are. And the first is procrastination, risk, fees, and of course, taxes. So let's start with procrastination. When you look at the average person, if we said, well, I'd like to have a 20-year monthly income at retirement, whatever that age may be, with an assumed interest rate of 8%, if I wanted to have $5,000 a month, what would I have to put away? Well, it's pretty simple at age 20. It's only about $113 a month. The problem is, what's happening at age 20? If you think back to when you were 20 years old, what were you doing at that time? Was putting money away for the future on the forefront? No, was having a good time, was going out with your friends, dating, that kind of stuff. Well, what about at age 30? Well, now you need more than double the money. The problem is now at 30, you may be married or may have been married with children. Well, now it's hard to save money. Well, in your 40s, well, I can't do it then, even though it's almost three times the money again, because now I've got kids, you know, travel, soccer, baseball, football, different types of sports that they're in, hotel rooms, you're spending a lot of money. Well, how about at age 50? Well, at age 50, the kids are going to college. So now I don't have any money. You know, it's all going out to tuitions. So now I'll wait till I'm age 60, and all I need to do is put away $8,100 a month for 5 years so I can have an income of $5,000 a month. So you can see procrastination has hurt a lot of people. And Americans, as a country, we are some of the worst savers in the world. Now, the question becomes, because I know you all know about 401ks and IRAs, is this the best place to put your retirement nest egg? Well, Time Magazine disagrees. They said, look, the ugly truth is that the 401k is a lousy product, a financial flop. Now, folks, we don't say that. Time Magazine said this back in October of 2009. And one of the primary reasons is the high risk. And what you're seeing here is a chart of the S&P from 1997 to 2012, or a 15-year chart. You know, and when you look at that chart, it looks like Rocky Mountains. It looks like a roller coaster. It looks anything but, you know, secure. All right? There's tremendous amount of risk in Wall Street-type accounts, and you weather that risk regardless of what you think you may or may not know in the marketplace today. As a matter of fact, most people have no idea how the market can be impacted by something that happens in another country. So there's a tremendous amount of risk when we talk about Wall Street accounts and 401k accounts. You know, we have to keep in mind that how do people find out about 401ks? They go into work one day and there's a notice that goes out and that says, we're having a meeting today in the auditorium or the cafeteria, and we're going to talk about your retirement plan. And everybody comes into a meeting and they spend about an hour there, and somebody is going over with them the different types of funds that they're putting their money in. And in 1 hour's worth of time, we're expecting people to become pension fund managers. The reason why you see people crying on 60 Minutes because they're retired and they don't have enough money and they thought it would be different is because they never understood the risk associated with these Wall Street type accounts. The second reason is the fees. This publication talks about the hidden costs of 401ks, and up until recently, they weren't even disclosed. The average 401k or qualified plan has a 2.99% fee. That's annually on the amount of money in the account. Now, folks, just to put that in perspective, 2% over a 30-year period of time would cost you half your retirement income. Just 2%. So just imagine what 3% is doing. The average 401k has $155,000 of fees per account per this publication. And the last one is taxes. Now this one here, most people today think we pay too much in taxes. But if you really think about the last 100 years since the IRS was born in 1913, there's only been two times in the history of the last 100 years where taxes have been lower than they are right now. In fact, right now our top marginal tax bracket is 39.6%. But if you look back into the World War II eras, it was 94%. In the 50s and 60s, as high as 91%. Try to imagine every dollar being able to keep only 9 cents. A big problem. So where are taxes going in the future? Well, We have to take into consideration that anything that is in a tax deferral type account, we have a partner, and that partner is the IRS. And you know, our government has not been the most fiscally responsible partner that we could have, and we have no idea where they're going. As a matter of fact, if you had an opportunity to opt out of the tax system and pay lower fees and never ever lose money again, wouldn't that make more sense? Well, where do you think taxes will go? Well, look at this chart. Since 1929, government borrowing has risen, and I'm not going to read it to you, but here's what it says. If you look at the gray here, this is government spending or government borrowing, excuse me. And if you look at the tax rates, they follow what the government has done. So you can see here right in the World War II era in 1945, you'll see the government spending or borrowing went way up, and look at the taxes. taxes were as high as 94%. And then you'll notice when government borrowing went down, look at what happened to the tax rate. Well, look at where we are today, and let's take a look at where government borrowing is. Where do you think taxes are going? You're right. They're probably going to go up. If this chart is accurate and it's over 85 years old, one would have to believe that taxes would have to go up. So therefore, when we look at the four retirement phases of retirement planning, the first one starts with the contribution. If we look at the typical qualified plan, IRA, 401k, what have you, it is tax deductible. So what are we actually saying? No, I don't want to pay the 39 cents on a dollar today, and I'm going to defer it to the future, where based on the previous chart, more than likely taxes will be going up. So what we're saying is, I'm going to take a tax deduction today. I'd rather not pay the 40 cents today to probably pay it back later in the future. Wouldn't it make more sense to know that we've got a finite number, 40 cents, pay the tax today, not defer it out into the future? Because when you do decide to take the money out, when it has accumulated, now that's when the taxable consequence is going to come into a place, meaning when you withdraw the money or when you're transferring it to a non-spouse, spousal heir. What's the alternative? The alternative is what we consider to be a tax-free alternative. You don't take the tax deduction today. It is still classified as deferred. However, when you need it the most, it is a tax-free benefit. When it transfers to your heirs, it's a tax-free benefit. So our solution is pay taxes now on the seed or pay taxes, higher taxes, later on the harvest. So what's the solution? Well, we call it the tic-tac-toe of finance, where you win every time. See, most people today, anybody who's putting any money away, investing or saving money, what they really want is safety of principle. Nobody ever wants to lose money. But the only place you can do that is in what we call fixed products. That's bank accounts, CDs, savings accounts. But those are typically associated with low rates of return. The opposite to that is upside potential. Well, that can only happen in, we call them variable products. However, those are Wall Street type accounts. The problem is the risk is still associated with those accounts. So in order to have the upside, you've got to be willing to risk the capital. Well, that's why we call this the tic-tac-toe of finance. It's called index products, where you get the safety of your money, but you also get the upside potential. As a matter of fact, the best kept secret, the underused and until now overlooked IRS Section 7702, your money never goes backwards. All your gains are locked in. It's absolutely 100% liquid, access to cash anytime for any reason without penalties, and yes, it's tax-free. The secret of the ultra-rich have been publicized by many different authors. Two in particular here, and this has become a national bestseller, The Tax-Free Retirement by Patrick Kelly. This talks about the alternative tax-free retirement planning. In fact, another publication from or an author called Richard Hinderer, he's a CLU, he writes Common Sense Retirement, How to Get 300% More Spendable Income, What Wall Street Doesn't Want You to Know about Your Money. Well, let me ask you a question. Who wouldn't want to have 300% more spendable income? So if we go back to a chart I put up earlier, and we call this red line, and you'll see this is just a little blown up here. This is the S&P over the last 15 years. You'll see that it's a pretty rocky road. However, what if you could have something like the blue line? So if you knew nothing about our business and nothing about investing, and I showed you this one chart, and I said, if you had an opportunity to take $100,000 and put it away, what line would you want it to be on? Would you want it to be on the red line or the blue line? Well, I'm sure you'd all pick the blue line. And there's a number of reasons why. Number one, it's got a higher value at the end of the 15-year period. But looking at it more closely, what do you notice about the blue line? Well, it doesn't quite go as high as the red line. But look at what happens when the red line goes down. That stock market declines. What happens to the blue line? It stays the same, meaning it never goes backwards. Again, when it goes up, as it did back in, 04, 5, and 6, you'll see that the blue line went up, not quite as high as the red. But look at what happened in 2008 when most people suffered a 38% loss. Look what happened in the blue line. So your money never goes backwards. It only goes upwards. And by the way, folks, this gets worse. Because if you look at the red line, the one thing that's not factored in here, because this is what the S&P has done, which is one of the leading indices used for comparison purposes because it's the most stable, what's not factored in here is the fees. Well, let's take 3% of 100,000, 3% of 117, 3% of 140. As a matter of fact, whether it goes up or down, you pay the fee. And as a matter of fact, you get penalized if you do well, because the more your account grows, the higher that fee is per year. 3% of an ever-increasing number means that you have an ever-increasing amount of fees that are associated to your account. So if you took 3% out of this over the last 15 years, that's at least another $45,000. And there's one last piece of this here is taxes. Of course, this is not factored in for taxes. This would all be 100% taxable. Now you understand why most people have said this has been the lost decade. I have gone nowhere. I was better off 10 or 15 years ago than I am today. Statistically, that's true, because most people have their money in these type of accounts. Okay? Problem number two, folks. 70% of the population will suffer a critical or chronic illness such as a heart attack, stroke, or cancer and live to age 65, but may be financially crippled in the process. This is a serious problem, folks. Every year, over 6 million Americans suffer a heart attack, stroke, or cancer. As a matter of fact, 1.2 million Americans suffer a heart attack every year. 17.6 million Americans alive today have survived a heart attack. So what does that tell you? That tells you that medicine has evolved, awareness has evolved. So there are more and more people today, as opposed to years ago, you had a heart attack, you just died. Now more and more people live because of awareness and medicine and innovation of medical services. Same thing with strokes. Each year, almost 800,000 people suffer a stroke. Many end up with permanent disabilities, but they're still alive. Cancer, 3.5 million new cases a year. Average cost, over $140,000 of expenses. Over 65% of the expenses are indirect and not covered by traditional insurance. So there are 11.7 million people currently living today with cancer. But what do? See, you can protect against these type of things with different types of insurance, right? So when we talk about someone who has a disability, well, if they purchased disability insurance, well, they would be protected, right? If they purchased life insurance, they would be protected, of course, if they were to die prematurely, right? As a matter of fact, they call it life insurance, but in reality, is it really life insurance? Most people who own life insurance realize that that is a benefit paid to someone else. So is it really life insurance or is it death insurance? Critical illness. You could buy a plan to cover critical illness. You could also buy an insurance program that covers a chronic illness like a long-term care. The fact is, all of these are important, but all of these come associated with the cost. Well, so what's the solution? Living benefits. What if there was a plan that would protect against critical illness? So if you had a heart attack, stroke, cancer, or major organ transplant, you'd be covered. Chronic illness, unable to perform two of the six daily living activities, or cognitively impaired, or a terminal illness. And you could have these all at no additional cost with the right product or the right service. So what if there was a product that protected you and your family from market risk without losing the upside potential? That provided liquidity without restrictions, allowed access for college education for your children, protected you and your family from financial devastation, solved the issues of critical, chronic, and terminal illness, all while providing for a tax-free income that you cannot outlive. Well, there is. As a matter of fact, we have a solution for every family, and there's two products that may cover many financial needs. The first product is term insurance. Most people are familiar with term insurance. It's real simple. It provides an income tax-free death benefit. You have to die for someone to get the money. There are no living benefits, and essentially, you have to die to use it. Well, that's the old term. Now there's a new term. The new term still provides an income tax-free death benefit, but it also has a no-cost critical, chronic, and terminal illness rider that can have up to a 90% payout while you're still alive. It's a fully convertible product to a permanent form of protection, but it provides living benefits, meaning you don't have to die to use it. You can be paid while you're still alive to cover situations that may occur. The second product is what we call Index Universal Life, and it is truly the retirement solution. This is what the banks and wealthy have been doing for years, and we just bring it to everyone else now. Again, it's called Index Universal Life. We call it the Swiss Army Knife of Finance. Tax-free money when you need it the most. See, folks, we got you covered. If you live too long, or you get sick, or you die too soon. So it's life insurance you don't have to die to use. Problem number three. 44% of the adult population cannot meet their financial obligations due to economic conditions. A lot of things have changed for people in their lifetime. And one of the reasons is, you know, we've got so many people in this marketplace today that need common sense financial and retirement solutions. If you look at the average family across this country, income is down $4,300 per family since the beginning of the year. There are 82 million millennials. These are kids, really, between the ages of 20 and 34. 50% of them are current college graduates with no jobs. 23 million people out of work in the Generation X market of, you know, 35 to 47-year-olds. 77 million baby boomers. We all heard a lot about them. As a matter of fact, we know that every day 10,000 turn age 65, and we've always talked about the impact baby boomers would have on Social Security, but what about the impact that baby boomers will have on long-term care when 90% of them don't own a product that can protect them if they should ever need that care? And last but not least, our existing seniors, 47 million people on food stamps, and of course, the $17 trillion we've already talked about in qualified plans, which is probably the biggest tax trap reported to the American consumer ever. In fact, Rick Buter, just another publication of the great Wall Street retirement scam, what they don't want you to know about IRAs, 401ks, and other plans. So what's the solution? Well, we call it the tale of two brothers. Our story begins with two brothers, both age 35, both saving $600 a month, both earning 8% interest for the same period of time, 30 years to age 65 or the retirement age. Brother A believes in the old way. Save for retirement in qualified accounts, receive a tax deduction, and pay taxes later. Brother B believes in the new way. Save through the innovative product called Index Universal Life and receive tax-free income later. So Brother A contributes $6,500 a year into his 401k, and he gets an employer match of another $1,000 a year. And what he does is he buys an old term. You know, he pays $680 a year for a $600,000 term policy, which will cover him for 30 years. Brother B, on the other hand, decides not to take the 401k contributions, no employer match, and he puts $600 a month into an Index Universal Life with a $600,000 benefit. Well, let's see who made the right decision. 30 years go by. Brother A has accumulated $158,000 in his 401k. He no longer has insurance because he had a 30-year term, and that has now expired. Unless he wants to continue to pay $12,000 a year for that insurance, but he did save $65,000 in tax deductions, so he has a total of $858,000. Brother B has $709,000 in his cash value in his Index Universal Life. Still has a death benefit of $864,000. He has no cumulative tax deduction. So when we look at the sum of money, Brother A's got $858,000. Brother B has $709,000. But it's not how much you make. It's how much you keep. Well, let's look at the most important thing. And that is distribution at retirement. How much money will this provide as an income stream when you're retired? Well, Brother B can take annually $97,000 a year from his Index Universal Life plan forever as a tax-free loan. If Brother B dies at age 100, he would have received over $3.3 million and left his family over $3 million in a tax-free death benefit. Well, Brother A, to have the same money, same amount of money come out, he has to take $129,000. Why? He's got a partner. That partner is the IRS. So at a 25% tax bracket, for him to end up with $97,000, he needs to take out $129,000. Well, unfortunately, Brother A runs out of money in 9 years at age 74, completely out of money because of the taxes associated with that account. So which plan makes you feel more financially secure? As a matter of fact, I've got two questions for you. Number one, if you were Brother A, would you want to be Brother B? I'm sure you would. And if you knew someone who was Brother A, would they want to be Brother B? Well, I'm sure they would, right? This is essentially taking someone from the red line to the blue line. Every time we do that, folks, every time we help a family just one time a month at an entry-level position, you earn as much as $1,200 per month just to help one family. That's over $14,000 a year part-time. And you know what? If you just did it twice a month, you could earn up to $30,000 a year. And there are many people in this country today not earning $30,000 a year annually. Now, just before I get into a little bit more here on the entrepreneurial side, here's what I want to get across to everyone. Let's not lose sight of what $1,200 does for a family today. If you think about your present situation, whether you're married, have children, doesn't matter, whether you own a home, what would an extra $1,200 to $2,400 a month coming into your household mean to your family right now? As we move on to potentially larger incomes, we don't want to lose sight of the value of extra income to a family. However, for those of you that are, you know, have the real entrepreneurial spirit, I liken our business a lot to real estate in this respect, that, you know, the real estate agency, typically you have two positions in a real estate agency. You have a broker, and the broker typically owns the company, and you have agents that work with or for the broker. And essentially, every time an agent makes a sale, they actually earn 3%. But when the broker makes a sale, they earn 6%. So in fact, they earn a 3% royalty or override every time one of their agents makes a sale. So as it relates to real estate, I'm sure if you were going to be in the business, you'd probably rather be the broker for a couple of reasons. One, because you're in control of it. And secondly, because you earn a lot more money. And now you're building an income that you are not solely responsible for. Well, here's one fundamental flaw in this type of agency type system, is that occasionally you're going to have agents that are aggressive, that are pretty happy, that have done well for themselves. And here's what happens. They're going to come in someday and they're going to say, listen, I appreciate all you've done for me the last 2, 3, 4 years. But you know what? I've decided that I want to become a broker. And they actually go out there and they open up their own realty, maybe even down the street from you, and maybe even take one or two of your agents. So in this type of system, you've trained your competition. And what we have is a completely different model from this here. We call it more of a profit share program. Now, our profit share program, we have some entry level positions here where we talked about the $1,200 or $2,400 a month, and that was based on a sales manager type position. We also have a VP position that is similar to the broker position, and this is more of a six-figure type income potential for these positions. And they, too, have the same opportunity as a broker does to go about there and add additional agents to their business. And why would they do that? By duplicating their efforts and teaching other people, they're able to build a passive income that they're not solely responsible for. So in the same scenario of a VP who goes out there and starts bringing on some agents and training them, he, too, or she, too, will have some people, and I'll use Bill, Mel, Pat, Sue, and Tom, that choose to go off on their own, maybe open up an office for themselves, maybe move to a different part of the country. But here's the difference. In our system, you would earn from 9 to 20% on all those people. So if you look at the system, our system is designed where you never lose the top producers, and you're building a more cohesive team. If you're willing to spend your time educating and training other people, you will ultimately build a passive income that is far greater than what you can do personally. So let's look at the potential six-figure income type opportunity. Here's an example of an average client, by the way, spending $300 a month. If you looked at the tale of two brothers, we talked about $600 a month. Here we're just using $300 a month, which is our average client nationwide. And here's a business, if you built what I consider to be a small business of just six sales a month, perhaps you're helping two families a month and you got four other people in your business right now for a total of six families a month. That's $129,000 a year income for just helping six families each and every month. Folks, that's a six-figure income. If you take that business just a little bit larger and you actually help one family a week yourself and have an additional six sales or a total business of 10 sales a month, that's a $220,000 plus income. But more importantly, if you look at the difference between $138,000 and the $220,000, you'll notice that now half of your income is from what you do personally, but the other half came from you working with other people. Well, just as you can build a business of 6 to 10 sales a month, so can other people. And you will find, you know, like Bill, Mel, Pat, Sue, and Tom, and they want to do the same thing. So let's hypothetically say you had a business that now grew to 110 sales a month. And that's really you not doing any more work other than doing what you're already doing. But you've duplicated your efforts through some other people, and they've chosen to build their businesses as you have. Well, look at your total income now. It'd be as much as $447,000 income, and nearly three times or nearly 75% of your income is not from what you're doing personally. Now, this is a true passive income that you can have some real quality of life. And why can this all happen? It's real simple. We use a system. When you look at companies that are successful, we look at a company like McDonald's. You've all heard of McDonald's. What makes them so successful? It doesn't matter where you go, whether you're in Aruba or you're in California or you're in Kansas, you go into a McDonald's, they all run the same way. They all sell the same products. They're all sold the same way, everything, and that's a system. And that system is why it has become a very successful company and franchise opportunity. When you look at Starbucks, they're unique in that sense as well. They pride themselves on customer service. They've got all their locations look the same. They all sell the same products. Very, very unique system. But the system is why they've become successful. Well, Freedom Equity Group has a system too, and our system is in the financial service business. In fact, our goal is to have 50 offices in every city across America because we believe that we can solve the industry's number one problem, and that is prospecting. So what makes us different, folks? Freedom Equity Group is a different kind of company because we have a crusade. Our crusade is to teach people how to retire with dignity and how to protect their family along the way. We have higher commission payouts than the competition, which really put us head and shoulders above any type agency that's out there. We do a ton of training. We take great pride in teaching people what they need to do. We do anywhere from 5 to 7 hours of live weekly training each and every week to show our producers how to become more successful. And I think the 30 years of experience, the clean track record, the compliance-minded, and frankly, the long-range decision thinking of our ownership is really what sets us apart from the competition. Okay, we're in it for the long haul, folks, building value for families. And getting ready to close this out, I'd like to just ask you, are you reaching your full potential? See, there's a lot of different triggers, or there's a lot of different reasons why people do things, and I'm sure there are several reasons or some reasons why you want to earn some extra income. And it could be, and for those of you that want to earn a substantial amount of income, maybe it's because you're not living in the dream home you'd like to live in, maybe driving the cars you'd like to drive, or taking the vacations you'd want to take, or frankly, just putting enough money away for your retirement. For me, my motivation has never really been about money. My motivation has always been about freedom. the freedom to work when I want, play when I want. If I want to take a day off to spend time with my family, I don't have to ask anybody for permission. That's the type of opportunity you have when you're an entrepreneur. And in our business being one of the, if not the largest industry in the world, the financial service industry, last year paid over $52 billion to producers. It's an extremely lucrative, and it will give people that opportunity to do that. So where do you see yourself? Well, there's a few different places. You might see yourself as a client. Maybe you heard the part of the presentation that talked about term insurance, but the one you have right now is the old term, where you have to die for somebody else to receive the benefit. Maybe you just want to switch that to a term, upgrade that to a term that has living benefits. Number two, maybe you like the tax-free retirement solution. You don't want the government in your affairs when you retire, and you'd like to have a vehicle that provides you a tax-free alternative money that you can't outlive. Or in addition to that, maybe you do really want to earn some extra income. You know, a part-time builder with us can work, 8 to 12 hours a week and earn an additional $5,000 to $10,000 a month of income. Or maybe you see yourself being a full-time builder at some point in time where you decide that, you know what, you don't like your job, you don't like your boss, you'd like the opportunity to control your own destiny, and that's a six-figure type income in our business once you've learned our business. So what's the next step for you? Set up a one-on-one meeting in the next 24 to 40 hours to see if it's right for you. You can do that live or online. Get your questions answered. Learn about our training program. See what we do with our company from the inside. Determine how much time you can devote to this type of business to be successful so you can get involved in our training program. And last but not least, what type of income potential? You know, what's important to you is what you want to do with your life, whether it be to make $1,000 a month or whether it be to make, $1,000 a day is completely up to you, and our opportunity does that. So the next move is yours. Get back with the person who shared this presentation with you and get your questions answered. Thanks for listening in.